Now this is the time for session two. I kindly request Dr. G. Bhaskaran sir to introduce our second technical session speaker, Dr. V. Subrahmanyam sir, for this meeting. Over to Dr. Bhaskaran sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you very much. And we enjoyed that earlier presentation very much. And now we are going for the second speaker. Dr. V. Sivasubramaniam, Director, Circuit Spectrum, Environmental Research Center, Chennai. He is a very eminent personality. He has spent more than 25 years of teaching and acquiring the research experience in the field of algae technology. Mr. Sivasubramaniam has received a PhD degree in algal psychology and biotechnology during 1983. Since 1996, Sivasubramaniam has actively involved in developing algal-based technology to treat the industrial effluent and waste water and implement large-scale treatment system all over the India, so that he is a genius. And he is a pioneer in taking algal technology to handle effluent in large-scale industrial treatment plants. And Dr. Sivasubramaniam has guided 20 PhD students and handled several industrial projects and published more than 100 research papers, articles in the international national journals. He has served as a core committee of expert and second generation biofuels, Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, Government of India, and also he has occupied more than five committees as a member, monitoring committee member in the CSIR, DPD, NCPS, and also a scientific advisory committee member in DPD IOC. And he is also a chief editor of Journal of Algal Biomass Utilization and a member of review committee of Bioreserves Technology Journal. Member of editorial board in Seaweed Research Utilization Journal and assistant editor in the Engineering Science and Technology, member of editorial board of Indian Hydrology Journal and Krishnamurti Institute of Algae Technology. And such a personality, he is going to deliver a lecture on microalgae technology for industrial effluent treatment and restoration of polluted water bodies. This is a problem in the India. Most of the surface and groundwater are polluted by the industrial pollutions. We are putting on common effluent treatment plant and other things, but it is not success. But we want to learn, we want to take the message from him about the microalgae technology, how best we can make use of the polluted water and restoration of this water. I wholeheartedly welcome, on behalf of the Nanoscience and Technology and Center for Water Resource Management, sir, you welcome and give your lecture on this topic and enlighten us to go for how we can go for the treating the polluted water using the algae technology. Over to Dr. Sivasubramaniam, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, please.
And please allow my presentation. To be shared. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Please allow my presentation. I have to share. It is in the sharing mode.
You can share your content, sir.
Okay, I'll see. It is not there, right? I'm not getting it.
Sir, please share your screen, sir.
I'm trying to share, press that, but I get advanced sharing options only. Oh, no, now I got it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I've been pressing the wrong button, probably. Do you see my slide? I mean, screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
It's full screen mode, I think. Am I audible? I mean, my voice is okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So normally,
yes,
sir. I talk from my home where I have a very good broadband. But now I'm sitting in my office, but the net is not that good. Anyway, I'll try to make it audible. I mean, am I audible? No problem.
Yes, sir. Yes, please, sir.
Okay. So I'm going to talk about my experience in wastewater treatment, especially the industrial wastewater treatment, restoration of polluted water bodies that we have started very recently. But industrial effluent treatment, I've been doing it for the last 20 years, and I've got about 20 PhDs. And we started with a few industries, and the earliest industry we started was from Colombia. I think you can see in the picture, you see two of my colleagues are sitting here with a probe in the petroleum industry in Colombia that I'm going to talk about later, if it's the time. And very recently, we are designing a system where you have polluted water, treat it with algae, and then make the system to produce electricity. So this system is now being installed in Colombia. I'm just showing just one slide only. I'm not explaining it. So this is my team in Colombia, which we started some years back, and we have a company also there. So I belong to a private company, which is called Picospectrum, and we also have an institute that runs in Annanagar, Chennai, and we have a collaborative industrial in projects in Colombia also. We call this PyCore. PyCore is a joint venture company in Colombia between Picospectrum India of mine and then Core Biotech of this gentleman we see here. And very recently we signed an agreement and made PyCore as the company very recently. And we are going to do projects, PyCore remediation or also restoration of polluted water bodies in Latin America. We have started with Colombia recently, and this is one of the projects we started some time back. This is the Caribbean Sea, and this is a very small city called Espiritu, Colombia, and this has got a sewage treatment plant here that is enlarged to show you 1, 2, and 3 tanks here. In the surface, you can see 3 tanks, and if you see the algal composition of the 3 tanks, they look different. I mean, they're different in the color and composition. Also, they are different. So we are now working on a consortium to be used in this wastewater treatment system of a small city, Puerto Colombia in Colombia. So this is another project we completed in Slotkos in Camagüey, and near Barranquilla in Colombia. And we have actually designed a reactor, what we call a BF Plus, that is the center here. So this is a pilot plant for treating. So the large scale of the BF Plus, a large scale system of 200,000 barrels of wastewater treatment system is now being installed in Colombia, one of the universities where my collaborator is doing a PhD, and he is completing it actually. So this is what we got in the wastewater treatment system that I showed the sewage treatment, where we brown coal, we take out the algae and harvest it and then dry it, you get calorific value, very high calorific value, 3.8, and the brown coal is 3.8. So we are also working on how we can convert waste into energy. So this is another project that we have started in Colombia. I think if it is loading, I mean, if the video is loading. Hello?
Yes, sir, it's loading.
Okay, this is another project we just started very recently. And what you see here is a very small stream. And that goes to, I think it's moving, and that goes to a swamp here. You can see a swamp. It is two-part swamp. This is a big, this part and this part. We have started this part very recently, restoration of a swamp. And very close to the swamp, we have a small town called as, not even town, it's a small city, small village called the San Benito Bar, where we are actually engaging a school, very small school, and teach the school students of what is PyCore remediation, and they are making a lot of work on this and making charts and then educating the local people. So in Colombia, you are supposed to convince the local people if you want to do something in large scale. That is very good, in fact. So the picture I want to show you. Do you see a video running? Hello. This is a chef of Ketan. Sometimes it doesn't happen. That's why. So we can see here, we are going in a small car, and a guide vehicle is going before us in a remote place in Colombia. You don't even have a road there. So we reach this place, and this is a swamp, and a starting point of the swamp. And we are actually going to see the swamp. Okay. Okay, so this swamp we are supposed to restore. And very recently we got a project from the Colombian government. And out of many people who tried to get the project, we got it. So it's a very, very successful project. We have completed part of it. And last March, just before the COVID, I was traveling in Colombia. So all the pictures and the videos you have seen were taken just before the COVID lockdown. So I reached India just a week before we shut down from Colombia. So this is the school students that we have made a school. I mean, selected some school students to be the people to work on the basic things, and then make people understand, local people understand what is fibromation in their own language, Spanish. So that's the major problem in Colombia. Whenever I go to Colombia, what they speak, I don't understand. Now I'm learning Spanish. And this is the teacher. She's also with us now. So they are making charts and then reading material that can be given to the village people and local people to understand what we are doing. For Colombia, that is very important. Before you start any project, you have to make the people understand what you're doing. That's very good, in fact. So this is our team, and this is school teacher, and this is me. And yes, so we also met the people, local people there. And these are all the local people. This lady and this lady and these people. So we are actually explaining them what is fibromediation, what we are going to do in their water body, a swamp that is a very polluted swamp because of the local activities and the industrial activities. And there are a lot of questions, in fact. We are supposed to answer all the questions and then convince them before we start. So this is the site we have created in Colombia. I think it is going to load. You can see our algae production facility. So we have a central facility in Sucre district of Colombia. I think this is going to load. You can see here your facility, which is far away from civilization. You don't see any houses anywhere, nothing nearby. It is in a savanna area where you can see water tanks with green algae and also reservoir ponds. See, four small reservoir ponds, four bigger and four biggest reservoir ponds. And this is our laboratory, and this is where we actually filter and process the algae and then take it to the incineration sites. And this is the facility, actually. You can see the reservoir pond facility made in a savanna area, far away from civilization. I think you have to go in a road which is not there, actually. Now they are making roads and all that. And this is the facility I'm talking about. You can see no houses nearby. It's far away. So earlier, this place is known for drug mafia and all that. So now it is all safe. That's what I was told. So this is the tanker. This is the tanker that we use to take algal slurry to the swamps, the lakes, and then ponds where we want to restore the water bodies. And we can see there's about 10,000 liters of algae, phycor. So this is the swamp that we are supposed to restore. This will give you an idea about the aerial view of facility. So in March, I think 4th March, it is written there, we had a press meet in San Bolivar University, which is actually hosting us, so which is helping us in back here. So the entire day we met with the TV people, the newspaper, the local magazines, and then they interviewed us and took the videos and all that, and it was telecast in the local TV, and I'll show you some of the TV. News items a little later. There is a time, and this is the algae facility that we have created in Colombia, Barranquilla. Simon Bolivar University is actually hosting us, and they gave us space, so we have put up a little growing facility, and then for all the people who are working there. And very recently, on August 22nd, 2020, when we are all sitting inside homes for COVID, we were given an award, Latin American Green Award 2020, for our project in Pico Sucre. Pico means micro-radiation. Sucre is the place. So we won the Latin American Green Award for 2020 when we are sitting inside home for COVID. So this is a news item from TV that is talking about our facility. So this is the local governor of Sucre, who is visiting our facility after when we got there. So the governor is now still explaining our technology to the people. Hector Olympio Espinosa, the governor of Sucre. So we have actually restored another swamp in Colombia. This Colombia, this is the Caribbean Sea, this is Magdalena River, and in between you have a very big swamp called the Malagan Swamp. This blue line represents a stream, water stream, that's also polluted. That's actually, collects water from various places, and then it is getting dumped here. So all these places, we started filtering algae, and then started our treatment. This is the aerial view. This is the facility, and this is Caribbean Sea. This is the Magdalena River. So this river, Magdalena River, that goes to the Caribbean Sea. It's the Caribbean Sea, and then the Malacan Farm. A very good location. They want to make it as a tourist spot. So we have been now engaged by the government to maintain it permanently. So we got 98.35 radiation BOD. So we selected these spots where we charged with the algae we have grown in the industry farms facility. And this is the Leon stream that actually goes into the big Malacan Farm. We are now cleaning it. And that actually came in the newspaper. El Geraldo is a local newspaper, and they have put up a very big picture, and then our Hello, do you hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Am I out? Okay.
Yes, sir.
I said I've gone out of doing this thing. No problem. So this is a facility, the picture that came in the news that came in the local newspaper, El Geraldo, and that actually gave us a publicity. So this another project we have completed, control of common cyanobacteria by micro-radiation. It's a very big swamp, so hard swamp, and we are able to reduce the toxic cyanobacteria to 90% to 100% in 3 to 6 months. So it's a very, very successful project. I don't want to go into detail for this, but yes. Okay, I'll skip over this. And we have. I also visited one of the textile industries in Colombia in Barranquilla, where we have put up a pilot facility to treat. And the important thing about this pilot facility is it's the first time in the world, continuous process. Normally we install a semi-continuous process. I will explain it later. There is a time. This is called a continuous process where we got very good results like VOD, COD reduction and color and also toxicity. You can see the pictures, the raw effluent, the final treated effluent of the textile industry in Barranquilla. So we mainly focus on industry and also the natural water. So this is another project we are going to start, and we are in process of discussion with the Welsh Water. And we have a team from Swansea University. This lady is Dr. Ella, and this is Carol, and this is me, and this is Dr. Thorjanin, man from Trichy University. So we are going to put up a facility here for treating one of the sewage treatment plants run by Welsh Waters. And we also visited Tata Steel in UK. So this is in Port Talbot in Wales. I visited Tata Steel and gave a talk on restoration of water bodies. After I returned from UK to India, I was called by the Tata Steel India. This man is head of the environment in Tata Steel Jamshedpur. So he called me, why don't you visit us? So I visited them, and they have a problem with the plant they have that was installed in 1974 with the Arabic and anaerobic bacteria. So Arabic bacteria is not doing very well. So what we thought was we can combine the algae with Arabic bacteria and do this treatment process, improve the treatment process. So we tried this in the laboratory. What we see here in the test tubes, you see the brown color, and the color becomes it becomes colorless within 4 hours, and there is a reduction in color, cyanide and ammonia. So we also put up a facility there. I just skip this. So this is the actual facility. This is where we are going to intervene, and these are all the railway tracks, the 4 railway tracks. I'm just showing this to understand how big the much volume that we are going to be talking about. So for 4,800 cubic meter, that we are going to use. So we actually installed a pilot plant. So this diagram of the, so we installed everything that was there in the large scale plant. So that is the beauty of the engineers you have in Dutch State. So they just implement everything in small scale. This 8,000 liter pilot plant with lights and all that. Whenever there is no sunlight, we can use the lights. And very recently, we have scaled up a plant in Titan in Tamil Nadu, where they have installed the large scale system very recently for effluent treatment of their jewelry division, where they have a problem with the electroplating industry. And very recently, we have just completed a pilot plant of Tata Steel in Haldia, West Bengal. You can see here the water, the algal tank here, about 40,000 liters. And this is the evaporation setup. So it's an RO project, or nano project, so that we are going to evaporate it with the algal treatment system. And this was actually installed in December 2019, and we have completed the pilot. We are going to scale up. And talking about the wastewater management and wastewater regeneration, I think microalgae can oxygenate the water, eliminate water, and it can biodegrade organic and inorganic pollutants, and eliminate all harmful bacteria, and promote biotic life in the most natural way. So this is the plus point of using microalgae for restoration of polluted water, but natural water bodies. And we also have a technology called PhycoPlus technology, and also a product called PhycoPlus that will help to enhance the activity of the microalgae as well as the associated bacteria. So when we say microalgae, we don't target the bacteria. the symbiotic bacteria. So both the algae and the symbiotic bacteria jointly do the work very, very successfully in restoring the polluted water bodies. And they do it in sewage treatment plants and also in filtration ponds and all that. So this Mycoplus is a combination of nanotech-based micronutrients. So this is where the nanotech comes. Trace elements, growth factors, enzymes. So that is actually made by us. And it is sold, actually. So this is a project we just started in North India, where we have cyanobacteria dominating the polluted water body. The cyanobacteria actually produces hydrophore that actually captures the iron, that is iron scavenging done by cyanobacteria. When iron is not available, other algae cannot utilize nitrogen. So they cannot use the nitrogen because they don't have the access to the iron that is scavenged by the cyanobacteria. That is why the polluted lake when we started working on it, we found this polluted lake had this cyanobacterium that we had mapped that will not allow the light to penetrate. And the light is not going. Water appears black, high butane, fluorine, high coliform bacteria, and water becomes blackish. So when we treat, when we remove the cyanobacteria and duckweeds, light penetrates, the water becomes transparent. This BOD-COD is reduced for the sort of oxygen that is going up. No coliform bacteria, normal food chain is restored. So that's what we did in one of the ponds in near Aligarh, where you can see the first time the pond is completely covered with cyanobacteria and light is not penetrating. I think within a day or two, when we started spraying our product called Mycoplus and also adding some useful algae into it, can see the coat in the cyanobacterial mat disappearing. And after a week, you can see the bottom of the lake, water become transparent, all the parameters become normal. So it's just a comparison of before and after. So this boy is actually spraying our nanotech product on the in water. And this is the treatment table. The raw effluent and also treated after 2 weeks. You can see BOD-COD reduction more than 80 to 84%, and coliform bacteria 99.5%, and E. coli 99%. So that is the result that we got in the first project we did in India, and we are now doing a lot of projects in North India, especially in temple tanks and other water bodies. And you can see these are the temple tanks where you can see the reduction is happening very, very efficiently, more than almost 80% reduction of the parameters. So very recently, we have been given a project of Ganga rejuvenation. And we started this, the Mycoplus technology is also approved by the Ganga Restoration Group, and we started this project in Gulabi, and we completed the project on time and submitted, and we got very good results, and it's still going on actually. This is a pond restoration project we did in Bihar, where you can see before and after 15 days, you can see the water become transparent, and the cyanobacterial the bloom is disappearing. And actually, there was fish death happening earlier, and you can see the skin disease developing in the fish, and then fish dying. So when we started restoration, after the 15th day, the fishes become normal, and fish become very healthy and very normal, and the skin diseases disappeared. And we did another project with Janki Pond in Bihar, and lot of projects we have done in North India mostly. And very recently we started another project in Meghalaya, where they have a problem with coal mining. You know, the coal mining is happening all over Meghalaya. It is actually illegal, but our government is not able to stop it. And you can see the river, nearby river, one of the rivers, the water is very clean because it's acidic. 2.5 to 3.5 pH and nothing is growing, can see the sulfur coating on the rocks. So this river has been given to us for restoration. The water is not toxic, but the pH is low. So we have put up a facility, algae facility in Meghalaya, just before the COVID we started this actually. And it is still going on, and you can see the lights, red, blue and white lights we have put, and this is daytime. You can see the bamboo. We have used the local material bamboo for the first time for putting up these tanks. And we started those things on the 10th of November. And now we got very good results, and we have put up these check dams in a few places to just to stagnate water. And we also allow, because the water is very acidic, the people there, they don't use the water. Now the water has become 7, because 7 to 1.2. Now we are encouraging the local people to come and wash their clothes so that the water, even the lawyers' side also becomes alkaline. So this was taken on 12th December. It's now almost complete. Now we are submitting this to the Government of India. I think I can take another 10 minutes. 4:44, 10 minutes, and allow you to ask questions. And this is another river project we did in Maligaon. This Maligaon, actually, river is actually polluted by the sewage, and also there is a very big textile industry near the river called UT Textile. So we signed an agreement with UT Textile. We put up huge facility for treating their effluent. The effluent after treatment with a lot of algae is dumped into the river, and you can see the parameter, the upper table is before and the lower is after retreat. Diane, Mosam and Chandanpuri has different distances of the river. This is a zero distance. Chandanpuri is about 10 kilometers away from the source. So you can see here the COD is 188 and 10th kilometer before treatment. The same COD becomes 21 after a treatment at Chandanpuri. So more the distance the river travels, the algae and whatever material we put is also carried, and the treatment happens very efficiently. That's what we finally reported. And now we are getting more projects, and this is one of the projects we just started in Watts Lake in Meghalaya, where you can see we are actually pumping our algae and also the phycoplus into those for restoring. This is just 1 week old picture and video. We are restoring it towards lake. And I just skip all this. So this is another project we just started in Sriram. CCM Sriram in Kota, Rajasthan, where we are supposed to treat the water, fertilizer industry water, and reduce the parameters of COD, POD. So we have a partner from Delhi called Trinity Impact. So we joined with them and then do this project. And this is the raceway, not the raceway pond, it's a slope pond with three slopes. And these slopes are actually illuminated during night. So this runs 24 hours. We are getting very good results from this. So this is another project we started in Jaipur with Tata maintained sewage treatment plant of Jaipur. And you can see the wastewater is being mixed with algae. And we got very good results. And these are all current projects. So we are ready to get this the results from these. So these are all pictures to show you various projects that we have completed in various regions. We are doing it for the last 20 years, and these are all the major companies we have done projects with. And if I can take another few minutes, because this is what I given is only introduction, so it has taken more time. I will stop with this. I'll just go go to a few slides. I think if I can take a few more slides, still time. And the methodology is very simple. This is three levels: lab scale visibility, pilot scale at the industry, and scaling up. Lab scale feasibility is done for a week. We don't spend more than a week in the lab. And in the pilot, we spend 1 to 3 months with a 10,000 liter, 20,000 liter pilot. And once the pilot is complete, we just get. So we have isolated a lot of species of algae. This is the list of algae that we have in our laboratory right now. All of them are mostly isolated from industries. So what are the benefits, the advantages? Is you can correct the pH with algal technology. You can remove the color and odor with algal technology. You can reduce the sludge. And also BOD and COD can be reduced. And nutrient removal, including ammonia, and better management of RO rejects, and reduction in the operation cost. If the everything is working very well, you can get 90% reduction in operation costs. And you can always claim that because we are using algae, which is carbon fixing photosynthetic organism, and say you can mitigate carbon and also flue gas, the help in carbon mitigation. So I think I stop here and call for questions. And remember, I completed only the introduction, and I have about 60 industries to show. I think it will take 3 hours to complete. So I stop here, and I think that listeners can ask questions, and I'll be very happy to answer this question. But I'll be just playing this slide so that you can pick up something from the slide that I'm showing without any explanation. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. So any questions you can post in the question and answer section. Sir, one question they posted in question and answer session, sir.
Okay, what is that question?
Ranjit Kumar, he asked, sir, how tough is the eco restoration of Kuvam River?
I think Ranjit Kumar is my student, I think so. Because we tried to do something in Kuvam long back, no? But the problem is the government, when you are talking about natural water bodies and the sewage and all that, you are dealing with the government. And dealing with the government is not that easy. In fact, a few years back, I was invited by a company from Sweden, I think. So they have put up a huge office in Nungambakkam. So they invited me, and they have been here for the last, for the last more than 1.5 years. The engineering group, they have been measuring and then making data of sewage, pollution and the water flow in Kuvam. So that lady told me that your technology is the best one. So they took me to Kuvam and showed us the various sites, and we selected 5 locations and made diagrams and sketches, and then finally submitted the entire thing just before Madam Jayalalitha passed away. And still it is in the, I think it is not open properly, I don't know what is happening. But we have done a lot of work with Kuvam and with the company from Sweden, and it was actually Swedish company was invited by Jayalalitha government at that time. And since Madam is not there, and when we submitted, Madam was already admitted to the hospital, so she was not able to follow it up, and we didn't get any support later. Thank you.
Sir, another question?
Yes.
By Ilakia, what are the various algae to treat with wastewater?
I expected this. Actually, we have hundreds of species in our laboratory, mostly isolated from the wastewater regions and industries. And we normally go with the local species. And whenever we visit industries, we try to isolate algae from the industrial wastewater system area, which are already growing there and adapted to the local conditions. And that is normally used. In fact, in Colombia, they are very particular. We are not supposed to take algae even from other parts of Colombia. So I have to stay in the industry for a few days to isolate, collect the samples from the local areas so that that will be used. So we use plenty of algae, mostly the local species, isolated from the industry apiary. They're already adapted and acclimatized to local conditions. You don't need to train them.
So next question, any methods to treat leachate from the landfills pertaining to Indian scenario?
Yes, I think we have done work with leachate with the Hyderabad company long back. I think they can show you that it is there. Yes, we can, because leachate has a lot of nutrients and nutrients are good for growing algae. And algae can take up all the nutrients and then we can definitely, yes, I think I have those slides, I just show you. Sorry, it is not there. Anyway, but it is possible. I mean, leachate can be, because leachate has a lot of nutrients which algae actually love. So we actually introduce algae and associated bacteria. They actually grow very well and then treat the leachate. And we have done with Ramki, Hyderabad, solid waste management company. And the leachate that is coming out is the problem. So we have put up a facility long back, just before the, I think, some years back, some two or three years, three or 4 years back, we have put up the facility. I don't think we have the data here. For sure. Sorry. But it is possible, yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. So next question is there any way that we can use microalgae with duckweed cultivation?
Microalgae and duckweed. I think whenever duckweed is growing, microalgae will also be there. It's a natural combination, you know. They help each other, definitely. Yes.
Thank you, sir. So next question by Dr. Manju Bashni. She is asking how algae are grown in the laboratories, sir, and how to maintain pH.
So laboratory growing, there are synthetic media, which buffered media that you can use. And I don't know what she's asking, whether she's asking about growing algae in effluent with the pH correction and all that, or in the normal medium. In the normal medium, there is a big book on how to isolate, and then a lot of synthetic media recipes are available, which, you know, we normally use whole basil and chutin and CFTRA media. A lot of media are there, and depending upon the species and the requirements, I think you can select the species. I mean, select the recipe, or you can have your own recipe also. That's what we do.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. So next question is whether algal powder can be used for reduction of microbial contamination.
No, algal powder, I don't know whether you are talking about the powdered algae which is killed. So killed algae, I don't think it will, it may absorb something, but it will not be active. We need wet biomass, which actively growing cells. But it's a biological treatment, it's not an adsorption or absorption we are talking about.
Okay, so next question is there any treatment process done in Tamil Nadu River by PERC?
No, unfortunately, no. Because I told you earlier, the rivers, the lakes, they all belong to the government. And we are very happy to work with the private people rather than government, because, you know, the different governments have different way of dealing with these projects and then private people. And I don't want to go into details of what I'm talking about, but it's sometimes very difficult to work with the government. Right now I'm working with the Colombian government. It's very easy. Once you convince them, if they give 100 rupees, the 100 rupees will come to you without any reduction. It will reach you. But I don't think that will happen here.
Okay. Next question is, could you please tell us how the algal biomass from raceway pond was separated before discharging the treated effluent?
Okay. Actually, we never use raceway ponds for wastewater treatment. I think I have not mentioned it properly. So I didn't have time to explain individual systems. I only did the introduction. So we use what we call as a vertical system, or what you call a slope system, where we can even go in deep as 3 meters deep of a tank. And we have a slope on which the water is actually recycled with circulated with a small pond. We don't use raceway ponds. The main reason is not that we don't like raceway ponds. Raceway ponds occupy a lot of space. For 10,000 liter, for example, you can have a vertical system within 1 or 2 meters of square meter. Whereas a raceway pond, you need to put large area because they are very shallow. They can go up to 40 centimeter height of the water. So 40 centimeter height and 10,000 liter, it occupies a lot of space. The same tank with 2 to 3 meter deep and 1 or 2 meter diameter, it will occupy less space. So we work with we don't work with raceway ponds because raceway ponds will not fit into industrial area because industry, they don't have space.
So the same question asked by Ram Kumar. Sir, in Krishnagiri, Pennai River also polluted. You have any solution for that?
Definitely. If the government asks us to do it, definitely we'll do it. No problem. We have done a lot of river projects in Colombia and also in North India. I've not shown all this here. Right now, we are working with 2 or 3 rivers in Meghalaya and drains and streams in a number of places, running water definitely, and we can do it.
Okay. Sathri, we can move to next session. We are running out of time.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's good, but there are plenty of questions, sir.
I have more than 270 slides, but I finished only 50 slides.
Sure. One more session in the next.
Yes, we will have.
Sahutri, the other participants can also send an email to Sar to get, more clarity on the,
you can see our websites, PicoSpectrum.com or PicoPlus.com. We can see all the projects we are doing, and you can contact me. Definitely. A lot of students are coming here and doing short-term projects, and the lab is always full. Only for the last 3 days, it is not full. They have completed. We have asked them to go because of the COVID and all that.
Right. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your valuable time, and also it is an excellent talk, and certainly we are...
I have completed only the introduction, sir.
No, it is very informative for us.
Okay.
Yeah? It's the scaling of the process is not so easy.
Yeah, we deal with scaling up only. We work in the lab only for a week.
Right.
It's a waste of time working in the lab.
That's I think definitely.
Yes, the field conditions are completely different. Yes, you are right. So yes, we work only for a week.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for the wonderful lecture on microalgae technology on water treatment, sir. So you took us to Colombia to Meghalaya. We are inspired and learned the new facts from you, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Let us move on to the last technical session 3. So here I welcome Dr. K. Narmada, postdoctoral fellow at University of Madras, funded by Indian Council of Social Science Research. She expertises in environmental remote sensing and also published 15 research articles and 20 conference papers in various national and international journals. I kindly request you to introduce our third speaker, Dr. Srikant Vipula, sir, the gathering, ma'am. Over